Good morning, children. Welcome to another class of science. I hope you all are fine and enjoying learning from home. Today, we will talk about the topic seed dispersal from lesson number 1, growing plants. Topics which we will cover in today's lesson plan are seed dispersal by wind, seed dispersal by water, seed dispersal by animals, seed dispersal by explosion. Then there will be a small assignment for you and the links. You might wonder what is seed dispersal and why do seeds require it. Now, as you remember, in previous class we have taught you about overcrowding, that when seeds fall under the same mother plant, they don't get air, water and space to grow, and that's why they die. Now, how nature solves this problem? Nature scatters the seeds away from the mother plant, and that phenomena is called as seed dispersal. Have a look. This is the definition. The process by which seeds are scattered away from the mother plant is called as seed dispersal. Seed dispersal is carried by the wind, by animals, by water, by bursting, or we also call it as explosion. Let's explore it further. Seeds of certain plant are very light and have wings like structure or hair on them. Now, what happens to these seeds? Can you see this seed? This is maple seed. Then see, these seeds are easily carried away by the wind from one place to another. This is another seed. You know this seed? Dandelion. Yes, you have seen these seeds in the school. Now, these seeds are very light, so they disperse by wind. They are easily carried away by wind. This is called as seed dispersal by wind. Once they get the proper conditions and they fall on the soil, they germinate into a new plant. So please remember, the seeds which disperse by wind are maple and dandelion. See another definition. Some seeds of plant are spongy or have a fibrous covering which help them to float on water. Now, many of you might have visited the beaches and have seen some seeds floating in water. Can you recall the name of that seed? Yes. Now you might have identified. Coconut. Very good. Now, coconut floats with water, and this type of dispersal is dispersal by water. Water carries these seeds from one place to another. Examples are coconut and lotus. Now, identify this picture. This is a small bird carrying a seed in its beak. Now, a bird with a seed. Now, once it will not eat it, it will throw the seed away from the parent plant, and this will be called as seed dispersal by animals. Can you identify this picture? This is a picture of cocklibber. These seeds, they attach to the fur of animals or to the clothes of humans, and because they have spines, and they are carried away from their mother plant. Birds, as I have already told you, they eat the fruit and throw the seeds. Same way, some seeds are undigested and they are passed out of the body just like that. This is seed dispersal by animals. Examples, cocklibber and guava.
3.
Finally, we came to last method of seed dispersal, that is seed dispersal by explosion. Explosion means bursting. Now see, some plants, the fruit of them burst open when they are ripe, and this throws away the seed away from the parent plant. Like peas, beans, this method of seed dispersal is called as explosion. I hope you have understood this all topic very well. Fine. Now, these all are the agents of seed dispersal. After understanding this, let's go to the assignment. You have to do these assignment questions in your science copy. These are also given in the book. Answers are also given in the book. Finally, go through the links. I will also write the links in the description box. This will help you to understand the lesson very well. Hope you all have enjoyed today's class. Do well. Bye-bye.